Hey guys, back with a new review. Today I'll be covering something I haven't really done in a while, a G1 figure. Actually, two G1 figures. Today I'll be doing the Autobot Jump Starters, Top Spin and Twin Twist. I'm going to say beforehand that I don't know if there are more Jump Starters out there. I looked on Google briefly, and the only entry that came up for Transformers Jump Starters was the Wikipedia entry for Top Spin. So if there's more out there, let me know. I may actually want to get some more of these guys. The whole gimmick with the Jump Starters is that they transform on their own entirely. You can tell by looking at them, it's a very basic figure. You can see the arms, you can see the legs, you can see his head right back there. It's a very basic transformer, but the idea is it's one of those motors where when you pull it back, it'll shoot forward all on its own. When it shoots forward, gotta go ahead and do this real quick. I don't want to break it. I know this guy does it real easily. His little switch is loose, I think. There's a little switch on the front here that is synced up with the wheels, I believe. Yeah, see that? When you spin the wheel. Man, my nails are really long, man. But, see that? And when that's spinning, it releases the legs, it springs forward, and it transforms on its own. At least it's supposed to. I've had these guys for a couple of months, and I've only really tried to transform them successfully about 2 minutes before this video was made. So, it may work. I'm hoping it will. I just got to give a quick little bio. I've got my my ultimate guide here. The Wikipedia entry is kind of cool in these guys. They have an interesting backstory. Sorry if I have the sniffle. I have a cold, apparently, again. Top Spin. Now, from what I understand, these guys are brothers. That's what I'm guessing. They're both Autobots. Top Spin, his function is land to sea assault. His motto, the thrill is in the journey. His bio is about even for the most part. His speed is an 8 and his courage is 10. And his firepower is 9. So he's pretty skilled, I mean, for a little guy. Twin Twist, and the way I remember these guys is, well, Twin Twist for the drill bits. This guy is a drill. Twin Twist's function is demolitions. His motto, war is whatever I want it to be. Cool. His bio's about the same. I mean, these guys are really even. His courage is 9, you know, firepower 7, strength is 8. Their alternate modes, for both of them, it says Cybertronian spaceship. But to me, this looks more like a Cybertronian tank / drill, because it's got the treads on it on the side there. This guy, yeah, he's got wings. It's a spaceship. We get it. They actually sold pretty well in the 80s because they weren't your standard, you know, Transformer comes to Earth, scans a vehicle, and there you go. These guys actually had Cybertronian forms, even though they really didn't appear in the cartoon series. That's really all I'm going to say about this. Although I do have this out still so I can remember which weapon goes to what guy. So let's see. This one here, this Top Spins. I'm going to put that with him. And this guy goes to Twin Twist. I always forget which one goes to what. Alright, so I'm going to try to do these guys here. Let me zoom this out. Don't mind the book collection there. Let me pull this back because I'm going to most likely need the entire bookcase for this. And I'm sorry if this is really shaky. I know it's not really professional, but I want to try to get these guys to transform on camera. And then maybe zoom in on it. That'd be kind of cool. Alright, so what I do, and yes, hello, it's my arm. See, look at this, look at this. I hate the way I tan. I finally get a tan on my arm, and then I'm just uncooked chicken underneath. Alright, so I'm just going to try Top Spin. I'm going to try it this way. You pull back, alright? And it's going to click when you get too far. What I do, since I have a very limited area here, and it's not focusing at all, let out some of the little steam here, and then, oh. I should note that the Ultimate Guide says these actually transform properly about 40% of the time. So let's try just a little bit here. I actually had him land perfectly twice before doing this. fell off a bookcase. Yeah, this is really the kind of thing you can only do on a kitchen floor. And I'm sorry, but I'm not taking this camera into my kitchen floor to do a Transformer video. There you go. He actually did it. So now here we have Topspin. His robot mode looks actually pretty cool. Now his legs, you can't really do a whole lot because they're spring-loaded and they are connected. But his arms have, full movement. His head you cannot move, although... Oh, that's what that meant. In the guide, it mentions that if your Topspin doesn't, if your transport doesn't really transform properly, there's a switch back here. And if you adjust this, it'll supposedly help their transformation. But the writer of the guide states that that rarely really actually does anything. Oh, crap. I think this was his gun. I think. I closed the guide and I can't tell. But anyway, pretty nice looking gun form. It's full chrome. This guy does look pretty good. I mean, he's rather short. But, I like it. It's an interesting gimmick for this guy. Alright, now to try Twin Twist, which, like I said, mine is already a tad loose, so... And I don't mean loose as in that lady you see on the street corner every night. Nope. Alright. Oh, not to the wall. He almost hit Topspin. See, these guys, it's really... I should have known better than trying to do these guys here. And actually hit the edge. So hang on a second, let's try this again. Knocked off Topspin and it flipped. So I don't know. Maybe there's a science that I'm not getting here. Oh, see that? No, you didn't see it. It was off frame. All right, I'm going to try one more time. One more. Anyway, I think I tried two there, but this is how this guy looks. And did I just... There's his gun. I thought I misplaced his gun. But here we have... Twin Twist. He does look different from Topspin, which I do like. He's not just, some kind of direct clone. You can tell a difference in them, obviously. And pretty much you can tell their colors are inverted. Twin Twist has the gray arms, legs, and head. Topspin has the gray body with the blue arms, head, legs. Arm, head, I don't know. Arms, head, and legs. There we go. It's really all about you can say about them. Look in the back and it says, made by Takara in 1980 and then 1984, Taiwan. According to the guide, since I'm calling the guide, not the Hitchhiker's Guide, the Transformers Guide, you can get these guys separately for about $10 to $15. And you can find them in, mint condition in box, mint sealed box, loose, whatever. And yeah, they do have rub signs. I didn't notice that. And they actually still work. I'm always fascinated when I find an Ace Transformer with a rub sign that actually does work and it's really quick. But you can normally find them together for $10. I mean, these guys are really cheap to find and they have a really interesting gimmick. It doesn't work most of the time. And when it does, you need a really nice, long stretch of land, not just a bookcase, and not one that's apparently really bumpy with water damage. And I'm going to throw it out there. The main reason I did this review today is because yesterday I received my Transformers Collectors Club free figure of the combiner sets of Topspin. And I do want to do a video on this guy. I really do. But I'm going to wait until next year when I can cover all five of the combiners because the fifth one's not out yet. So this is it you're going to see of this Topspin until probably next April, next May, maybe next June when I cover all five of them and their combined forms. So get a good look at him. I like him. He looks really cool. I suggest joining the club and getting the exclusive figures. That's it for him. You're not going to see him again. As far as these guys, yeah, I definitely would recommend picking them up. They do look really good. A thing to consider, though, is if you do want to get a nice, cheap Transformer, make sure these guys have their stickers intact in some presentable way, so you won't have to pay a visit to Repro Labels and buy a whole new sticker set and set you back another $6 to $10. And also make sure that the chrome is in really good condition, which this guy, luckily, it's nice, it's shiny, it's beautiful chrome. This chrome is, yeah, it's about like that. But that's it, guys. I'm done with this review. Hope you enjoyed the look back at some G1 figures. But I'm done. Have a great day. See you around.